The big thing about being in North Korea is that you become incredibly paranoid and you become quite anxious that you're being watched all the time. You're being monitored inside your hotel room. You can't go anywhere without anybody else. So when we left, when we landed in Beijing, I don't think I've ever felt so free in my entire life. It took us 18 months to get in there, of writing emails, of making contact, of going through third parties. And then we had to get permission from our own employers. MFAT didn't want us to go. When I interviewed Winston Peters before I went, I asked him if anything went wrong, what could he do for us as foreign minister? He said nothing. Everywhere we went, we were followed by secret policemen. There were policemen. There were people who said they were journalists, people who said they were scientists, but they weren't. So one day, we were near the Chinese border. We were in some of the most sensitive parts of North Korea, close to the Chinese border. I thought, I can send a text, because I was picking up a signal. So I took my phone out, and I typed a text to my wife saying, we're all good. Don't worry, I'll call you when we're able to. And I sent the text. Next thing, this one of the secret police guys ran up, grabbed me by the arm, and started shouting at me. I got the interpreter over, and I explained that I was using my phone to take notes. And I thought this might happen, so I'd put in a little note on my phone, on Sindo Island in North Korea, people very friendly and nice. He calmed down, I put the phone in my pocket, and then I went down and sat with him. Halfway through that conversation, my phone went like that, and I thought, I'm not even gonna look at it. So I didn't look at it for 6 hours. It's like going to the moon. It's one of the only places you can go to in the world that doesn't have overt influence from everywhere else. It's a fascinating place, but I'm not in a hurry to go back there.